Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make any shape into the look of glass. I provided this brushed steel texture that you can download for the background. Its link is in this video's description or project files. Feel free to use another texture if you like. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click that subscribe button at the lower right to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. We'll place into it a black and white shape. You could also type in text if you want. Check your foreground and background colors. If they are not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. For the purposes of this tutorial, open your custom shape tool. If pixels isn't showing, open the flyout list and click pixels. Open the shape's presets and click the gear icon. Check small or large thumbnail and click a shape. Click the gear icon at the top and tick define proportions and from center. Go to the approximate center of the document and drag out the shape approximately this much. To center it accurately, press Ctrl or Command A to select the dimensions of the document. Press V to open your Move tool and click the Align Vertical Centers icon and the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. We'll convert the shape into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. It'll also allow us to replace the shape with a different one without having to redo the effects. Click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Reduce the fill to 0%. This makes the shape invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of all the layer styles we add to it. Make two copies of the shape by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Double-click the bottom shape to open its layer style window. I'll move it over so we can see how the layer styles affect our shape. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 15 pixels, and the soften is 10 pixels. Check global light. The angle is 60 degrees, and the altitude is 25 degrees. Open the contour list and click the gear icon. Click the large or small list and scroll to ring double. The highlight mode is screen, the color is white, and the opacity is 70%. As before, the shadow is irrelevant since its opacity is 0%. Click contour and open the contour list. Click Valley Low. The range is 100%. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is overlay, the opacity is 30%, and the color is black. Click the gradient bar and the foreground to transparent preset. The technique is softer and the source is edge. The choke is 15% and the size is 30 pixels. Open the contour list and click Steep Slope Rolling. The range is 50%. Click Satin. The blend mode is Color Dodge, the color is white, and the opacity is 10%. The angle is 90 degrees, the distance is 60 pixels, and the size is 10 pixels. Open the contour list and click Steep Slope Jagged. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is normal and the color is black. The opacity is 50%, global light is checked, and the angle is 60 degrees. The distance is 15 pixels, the spread is 10%, and the size is 20 pixels. The contour is linear. Double-click the shape in the middle to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, and the technique is smooth. The depth is 760%, the direction is up, The size is 75 pixels, and the soften is 5 pixels. Uncheck global light. The angle is 130 degrees, and the altitude is 30 degrees. Open the contour list and scroll to Cove Deep. The blend mode is soft light. The color is white and the opacity is 60%. The shadow is 0%. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is overlay and the opacity is 50%. Click the box and pick white. The choke is 0% and the size is 12 pixels. The contour is notched slope. Double-click the shape at the top and click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel and the technique is smooth. The depth is 260% and the direction is down. The size is 30 pixels and the soften is 4 pixels. Global light is unchecked. The angle is minus 140 degrees and the altitude is 65 degrees. Make the contour ring. The highlight mode is overlay and the opacity is 100%. The shadow is 0%. Click contour and scroll to peaks. The range is 100%. Lastly, we'll slightly enlarge and warp the background inside the glass. To do this, shift-click the bottom shape layer to make all of the shape layers active. We'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Click the background to make it active and convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount 50%. We'll need to invert the layer mask to reverse the effect so the inside of the glass is distorted while the background that's outside the glass isn't distorted. To do this, make the layer mask active and invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Open the folder and Ctrl click or Command click the shape to make a selection of it. Close the folder. We'll fill the selection with white. And since the foreground color is white, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.